I started learning Yiddish before I had a connection through my wife to Jewish relatives. And now what's really cool is I'm the only one, the goyish, guy that married into the family, who's the only one that has an interest in Yiddish, right? And so I'm sort of this curiosity, I guess, for them. It's like, this guy really is into Yiddish. It's really cool. I have this a couple little copies of this book, Say It in Yiddish, which is a little phrase book. And our daughter is 8, and her name is Clara Rose. She's named for her Jewish great-grandmother and great-great-grandmother. And just to kind of honor that tradition, because technically she is Jewish through the mother's line. And she saw this book and she said, "Say it in Yiddish. What a neat idea. Can I have this book?" And I said, "Sure, you can have this book." And it's nice because it's written in Yiddish, with Hebrew letters, but it's also written in transliteration. So it's like, "Vos hert sich," or something like that. And she goes, "Vos hert sich." She's sounding, "How do you say that, Papa?" It's like, this is cool, Her great-grandmother, great-great-grandmother never would have guessed, right, that this little girl in the middle of nowhere, Wisconsin, would take an interest in Yiddish. But she does, and that's cool.
Do you speak Yiddish with
Yeah,
her?
I do. Yeah, and we have, Yiddish children's books and there, things like that too. Yeah, I've read stories to her ever since she was little in Yiddish, among other languages too, but Yiddish happens to be one of them. And little kids suck up the language, and she happens to be just particularly interested in language generally. And it's like, and she knows that she's named for her Jewish great-grandmother and great-great-grandmother. So it's like, that's neat.